UK, big business. We linked up in the UK with them outlaws, no limit forever, and we mash hard and we stay by the shadow.
If I so-called diss somebody on Instagram or YouTube or whatever, I find out who they fuck with and I send it to all of them. Every last one of them motherfuckers. You understand what I'm saying? So he can't duck that fade. And to be honest, man, when I get at these rappers, man, I want them to shut me up, man. Cause I'm a student, man. I'm a student, so I learn from everybody. So even though I might get at a 2 Chainz or something like that. 2 Chainz was dead wrong, and I got at him for being dead wrong. But it's not saying that I can't learn something from him.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? He said some stupid shit like Atlanta running the game for the last such and such and such. I'm like, I keep hearing people say this shit. Even my homeboy Trick Daddy's be talking this craziness. I'm like, no matter how you want to look at it, the biggest artist is still right here. They still come from right here. They still here. And that shouldn't be like a smack to nobody's fucking face, because whatever started here moved out and everybody's eating from it. So why everybody quit to stop on New York City? I don't get it. I don't understand that shit, man. I don't get it.
I mean, I know you was at the recent Versus, and that was a good sign for, you know, just seeing that kind of hip-hop spirit back in New York and stuff again, man, because even me as a hip-hop fan, you always look to New York as, like, you know, really the mecca, really the leaders from the...
That's mama, you know, man.
Yeah, you know, that's where everything really come down from,
mama, man. What the fuck? Why is everybody so... I don't get it, man. Look, see, this is how the white man do. The white man took science, took mathematics, took all these things from us and make us believe that he started and that we the dumbest. You understand what I'm saying? People were here millions of years before these people. And then when these people, you know, had a medieval stage or was in caves and shit, we was building pyramids. But they still call us stupid, slow, dumb, all the bad words in the world, though you took our knowledge and you did whatever you did with it. And that's just the same thing as hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say this and say that about hip-hop, but they wouldn't wear the Chainz if we didn't rock the Chainz here. They wouldn't be... I know plenty of places. I was a guy... I've been on the street since I was 9 years old, and I was on the run most of the time, running from something. And when I was running to these different states and shit like that, a lot of states, they ain't gonna fuck about having those 3-4 pair of sneakers. But here, you had to. If you ain't had 3 or 4 pair of sneakers, you wasn't even coming to school. You understand? And everybody was poor.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So now everybody got a sneaker game. Think about it. All this shit, man, listen, man. I came up with you give respect where respect due, man. And that's that. Nah. I get tired of people coming at the city for what? I don't understand. This is where you got your game from. It's just like Greeks. Greeks went to Africa to study. You know what I mean? Give the respect to Africa and say, yo, we couldn't get the knowledge over here in Greece, so we went over there to Africa and learned from them people. We learned from the people who taught the people who taught the people, who learned from this one, who learned from this one, who learned from this one, who learned from this one. In Greece, we were savages. They should have said that, but that ain't what they said.
Now, I think, you know, the highest Greek scholarship does give credence to that, you know, learning from the Egyptians, the Ethiopians, and stuff like that. But not to go off topic, I guess staying on, I guess, where, you know, hip-hop and stuff is now, we've had somebody... they've said, what do you think of the music industry today with the mumble rap era that we're in? I don't like it, but they want to hear from your perspective, from somebody that's came up with hip hop from the original era and generation. And they said, "What are your sons, the Little Soldiers, doing now in 2021?"
Okay, I got a short mind span. Like, I write rhymes and forget the words to them right after I write them. Okay, so the first question is, far as mumble rap and shit like that.
Yeah.
Now this is the crazy part. When I came up in the game, you had to be responsible. You understand what I'm saying? Like Eminem would have got whooped out. He would have got beat up because you don't talk about your mama. Not no black fucking community. You get your ass whooped for talking about your own mama. If you, me and you, we boys, and I was like, man, fuck my mama. She's a bitch. Man, somebody gonna throw a punch at me. Because that's blasphemy in the black community. So I said all that to say, you had to have some type of responsibility when in my era, when you're saying the things you're saying out your mouth. So for it to exist, for a mumble rapper to exist, the responsibility has been taken out. There's no responsibility. Motherfuckers is free to say and do whatever they want. It wasn't like that in my day. You can say some wild shit if you want in your rap, and somebody's going to approach you on that shit. You know what I'm saying? PM Dawn, like I was telling you the other day, PM Dawn had an ill song, "Did You Send Me Out?" That's it. He had some other shit before that, but somewhere along the line, he said hip-hop, and he put hip-hop on what he was doing. And somebody got on stage, I ain't going to say the popular artist name, that got on stage and whooped his ass for that shit. Why? Because he said he put the wrong label on the wrong situation. And the label he put, this is hip-hop, and it wasn't hip-hop. And motherfuckers don't, you have to be responsible. So for there to be mumble rappers for a while back a minute ago and today still, that Lil Pump and all of them, nigga, you got whooped out. Whooped out. Whooped out. For speaking that type of shit. I mean, look at Jay-Z. When Jay-Z and I think Nas, they got something called ignorant shit. Some shit like that. Something like that. Even in that ignorance, it's a responsibility of what you're saying on that mic. Even though he said, the ignorant shit that you love to hear, some shit. Even in that ignorance, it's some shit that niggas is being responsible. You hear somebody like Crooked and Billy Bathgate talking about a lot of crime and shit like that. But you hear them say, yo, I was a young nigga, dumb nigga. Ain't just saying they was buck wild. They saying I was young and dumb. So there go the responsibility right there while you're spitting your ignorant shit. But the mumble rappers cats, they wasn't jacking none of that. They was just ignorant. What the fuck is you talking about, son? Fuck is that?
Join us on the line, battleonline.com for the hottest UK, US flavor. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to be updated on new drops and content.